So last time we introduced the notion of excision, and we stated the theorem of Mayer-Vitres, namely the excision theorem. And we gave some two easy examples of excision, namely the disk and the entire Rn minus zero, that is one pair. Another pair was the sphere minus the north pole and the upper hemisphere. In practical situations, often x1 and x2 are closed subspaces and they may not satisfy that their interiors cover the whole of space. So you cannot expect the excision theorem to be directly used. So we have to do a little bit of circus here. So there are a few of situations which can be taken care by the following lemma, which is quite an important thing. Namely, suppose A is a closed subspace and A to X is a cofibration. The inclusion map is a cofibration. Then the quotient map Q from X to X by A induces isomorphism in singular homology. H star of XA to H star of X by A star. So the role of putting star is, as you have anticipated, is same thing as taking the reduced homology here, H star twiddle of X by A. Taking reduced or unreduced on this part is doesn't matter. Okay, so if you don't put that relative X by A star. What is star? Star is the subset A identified to a single point here, is X by A. So that point I don't take. So I can write it as the whole singleton A. A, the entire A is a single point there. So without the cofibration condition, such a thing may not be true. Okay. So the relative homology is not the same thing as the homology of the corresponding quotient in general. We need to recall some important facts from part one to prove this one. Okay, this is not quite an easy theorem or anything, this lemma. The first thing was, which is easy, and it was left as an exercise in part one. So I will leave this also an exercise here just for your refreshing your memory. You work it out as an exercise. Namely, if A to X is a cofibration, then CA to X union CA is a cofibration where CA denotes the cone over A. A is already a subset of X. Only on the part of A you take the cone. Okay, so X remains same. Not the whole of X you are taking the cone, but over A you take the cone. So this is, then you get X union CA. So CA contains X union CA. This is a cofibration. The second thing is, if A is a cofibration, A to X is a cofibration, and if A is contractible, then X to X by A is a homotopy equivalence. Okay. So this is theorem 3.8 part B. There it was some other theorem perhaps, But here I have quoted this entire theorem. I need part B of this one. We will have to use here. So here you see, there is no hypothesis on A, like contract, that it is contractible and so on. Okay. Yet you can get homology isomorphism. The trick is to use this fact. Now, CA, which is a cone over A, that is contractible. Okay, so we can put this exercise and this theorem part B and get something. Okay, so that is what we are going to do now. So proof of the lemma 3.9. This lemma we are going to prove now. Okay, H star Q star from H star of XA to H star of X by A is a isomorphism. So I will recall what is the cone over A. Cone over A, the quotient of A cross 0, 1, where A cross 1 is identified to a single point. A cross 0 is identified with the subspace of A as it is. A cross 0 goes to A. Okay. By theorem 3.8b, okay, this one, combined with exercise 3.2, okay, what we get? We get that X union CA, X union CA mod out by CA, CA collapse it now to a single point. This is a homotopy equivalence because CA is contractible and CA inclusion to X union CA is a cofibration. Okay, so this, when you collapse the contractible part, this becomes a homotopy equivalence. Okay, next, to apply Mayer-Witter sequence now, what you want to do is take X1 as X union, the half part of the cone, namely 0 to half. The rest of them, you take X2 equal to CA. Now, CA and X1, CA is X2, X1 union X2 will be the whole of X union CA. Okay, and their interiors cover the whole thing. If you take the interior of CA inside X union CA, it will be the open cone, the image of A cross 0 open 1. All right. And the interior of X union A, X union A cross 0 half will be just this half open. So they cover the whole space. So we are fine, but there is actually a strong deformation retraction X1 to X. Okay. Sorry, what I have here is, yeah. X1 to X, X. See, you have a cone over A, but you haven't taken the full cone. You have taken only half part of it. The apex of the cone is left out. So you can push the whole thing back to X. So X1 to X, there is a deformation retract, which is identity on X1 intersection X2. Or X1 intersection goes inside A. So the deformation retraction is simultaneous. X1 intersection X2 would go inside A, whereas X1 itself is pushed to into the wall of X. So there's a deformation retract of the pairs. Okay. Therefore, the inclusion map here from H star of XA to H star of X1, comma X1 intersection X2, this is an isomorphism. Okay, so step by step, we have to build up this isomorphism, namely final isomorphism that the Q star has to be built up step by step. So now, with all this background, let us consider this commutative diagram. The top arrow here is what we want to prove, that it is an isomorphism. This just now we proved that H star of XA to H star of X1, X1 intersects X2 is alpha is an isomorphism. This is what just we proved now here. Okay. This is actually a homeomorphism. Start with X, A is a closed subspace, you collapse it to a single point. It's the same thing as putting a cone and then taking the whole cone to a single point is same as just doing this one. The inclusion map itself gives you a homeomorphism here of the quotients. Okay. So this is very easy to verify that this is homeomorphism. All right. So this is an isomorphism in homology. This is an isomorphism in homology. So now you can come to the second row here. X1, comma, X1 intersection X2, to X union CA to CA. This is the inclusion map. This is by excision. So this is where we have to show that eta is an isomorphism by excision axiom. Okay. Now what is this one? Beta X union CA. Okay. Comma point star here and CA the whole thing is taken. So CA is a contractible space. Therefore, if you use the homology exact sequence of the pairs, alternatively you will get, you know, CAs are all contractible zero maps you will get. Therefore, this is isomorphic to this one. Homology exact sequence of the pair will give you this one. In the last stage, you have to use this star. Till then, you don't have to use that. For the last part, you will get only the reduced homology. What is this one? X star, X union CA, star to X union CA, my CA. This is a quotient map, right? You have collapsed CA. We have verified that if this is homotopy equivalence is part of that what we have seen, because CA is a CA to X union CA is cofibration. And CA is contractible. So this is homotopy equivalent. So this P star induces an isomorphism. If this is an isomorphism, this is an isomorphism, P prime star, whatever map here, this again a quotient map in some sense. Okay, CA has been collapsed to a single point. This is also an isomorphism. So this is an isomorphism, this is an isomorphism, this is isomorphism, it's isomorphism. Therefore, this is an isomorphism, U star. So it takes so much of efforts to show that the Q star from XA to X by A is an isomorphism. Excision is used, cofibration is used, and a tricky this theorem is used. When you are contractible, then X to X by A homotopy equivalent. Okay, provided A to X is a cofibration. Okay, so what finally we have is a ready-made thing now, namely, sorry, this lemma, namely, whenever A to X is a cofibration, then you can collapse A, X to X by A, okay, that quotient map from XA relative to X by A star, this will be a isomorphism in homology. Now let us see how we can proceed further. Now come back to the situation of excision. X is A union B, where A and B are closed subspaces. If the inclusion map, one of them, A to X or B to X, is a cofibration, then AB is an excessive couple. Do you understand how now we are going to, we don't know whether X, whether interior of A and interior of B cover X. If that is the case, then you don't need this one. So I already illustrated this, such a situation, namely, when you have written sphere as the union of upper hemisphere and lower hemisphere. If you take the interior, they will not cover. Okay, so there are many other situations like this. So an alternative approach is that they are close-up spaces. The inclusion map of one of them is a cofibration. Okay, you must remember that cofibration implies that the subspace A is a strong deformative tract of a small neighborhood of A inside X. So that is the key here, which works because of this one. But we are going to do it in a slightly different fashion. We shall prove condition E of lemma 3.8. Remember, there are five different conditions for the excision. Okay, so we can use one of them, any one of them. So condition E will prove. This is same as showing that H star of B comma B intersection A to H star of XA is an isomorphism. So this is what we will show under this assumption. Okay. Note that A to A union B is a cofibration implies B intersection A to B is a cofibration. Okay, this is similar to the exercise here. This exercise, A to X is cofibration, the cones are cofibration. So this is similar to that. Okay, maybe easier than that. So we have A to A union B is a cofibration. B to A union B may not be, but B intersection A to B is a cofibration. We now consider the quotient map X to X by A. So we want to use this lemma. Okay. Since B is a closed subspace of X, it follows that the restriction map B to X by A, which is B, you can take this as because of the excision part, okay, B modulo B intersection A. You can restrict the whole map instead of X, take B itself, so B and then its image B modulo B intersection A, because what you collapse is only B intersection A part. This is a quotient map. Okay, therefore, from the above lemma, both Q and Q prime induce isomorphisms in the relative homology. Okay, the isomorphism B to A, B to B intersection A, and X to X intersection A, XA to X by this one, they are isomorphisms. Okay, B to B intersection A, B comma B intersection A to the quotient, namely B by B intersection A, you can go, but that is same thing as X by A, but that is given isomorphic to H star of XA. So you have a diagram like this and come back. So this is an isomorphism. Okay, from B comma B intersection A, you go to B modulo B intersection A. But that is same thing as X by A. Then you go back by H star of XA. That's an isomorphism. Q and Q prime are isomorphism. And bottom, they are equal. So the top thing here is an isomorphism. So if one of them is a cofibration, then we have A union B, A comma B is an excessive couple. So here is a corollary. Take a pair X1, X2 of closed subspaces of a space. Okay, this is an excessive couple for singular homology under the following conditions, either A or B, whatever. Xi, X1 intersection X2 is a relative CW complex. X1, comma, X1 intersection X2 is a relative CW complex, or similarly, X2, comma, X1 intersection, they must be relative CW complex. Then X1, X2 will be excessive couple means you can go to x1 union x2. Okay, similarly, the other one is now simplicial complexes. Xi is modulus of Ki, where Ki are simplicial subcomplexes of a simplicial complex K. With K, go to the union of. Suppose you have two subcomplexes of a simplicial complex such that the union is all of K. You have proved that inclusion map of any subcomplex, whether it is a simplicial subcomplex or a CW subcomplex, the inclusion map is a cofibration. And of course, subcomplexes are always closed. So this corollary is direct corollary, as its name says, from this theorem. Okay. They are cofibrations, therefore. So this is a very, very useful thing. You take a subcomplex. Okay. So there is no way to get open subsets and so on. You don't have to worry about that part. We have done that kind of things also. Neighborhood retracts have been proved, but co-vibration is, you have to remember, that is much stronger than anything else. The close is, you have close subsets of this true. By the way, this was the way one of them, I think it was when Kampan, he proved his own version of what is called as Venkampan theorem for fundamental groups, for subcomplexes. For open subsets, it was the Seifert who has proved that. Okay? And they didn't know each other. It is not a joint work. In Europe, they will call it Seifert's theorem. In America, they call it Venkampan's theorem. Okay, so all that you have to use is 1.13 and 39, statement B is special case of A. Okay, statement B is special case of A because they are simplicial subcomplexes are simplicial complexes are simple CW complexes, and simplicial subcomplexes are CW subcomplexes. For A part, you have to use this theorem 9 and then cofibration. 1.13, you just say that they are cofibrations. And closed subspace, of course. Okay. So finally, we will produce this ready-made long exact sequence due to Eilenberg-Stein rod out of this theorem. Okay. So this is just another step. It's not rebirthing, it's just putting it in this fashion. It helps to compute things very much. So we shall concentrate on putting the excision theorem to good use by first deriving an important ready-to-use result. So start with x1 and x2 in excessive couple, whether they are open or cofibration, somewhere. Excessive couple, okay? In the long exact sequence of homology groups, namely, of H star of X1 plus X2, H star of X1 direct some H star of X2, and H star of the intersection. This H star of S1 plus X2 can be replaced by H star of X1 union X2. That is the gist of the excessive couple, the statement excessive couple. So what we obtain is Hi plus 1 of the union instead of Hi plus 1 of Sx1 plus Sx2. So you just put the union of these two. Then there is this connecting homomorphism to Hi of X1 intersection X2. Okay, so one index lower. Then it will come continue Hi of this one, this I star. Is the inclusion, remember, x1, x2, h1, x2. What is this one? This is inclusion, comma inclusion, I star. Then J star is inclusion A minus A1 minus A2. So that's what you have to take for x1 and x2. So that is the way we have defined this exact sequence here. And then again, there will be a jump to hi minus 1 and so on. It will go on till we hit h0 of x1 unit. Last three terms are here. H1 of x1 and x2, delta. Delta is the connecting homomorphism. Goes to h0 of intersection to h0 of the direct sums. Then h0 of the unit. So this is what you have to use now. This is called Mayer-Vittrey sequence. So in honor of Mayer-Vittrey's who have proved this one, Eilenberg-Steenrod have called this one Mayer-Vittrey sequence. Okay. So I have given you the formula here. What to recall? I star of Z is I star of Z minus I star of Z2 have put. I have deliberately changed it here. You can take plus here and minus here. No problem at all. Okay. You can minus here if you put, you have to take plus here. Both the conventions are existing. Okay. So the exactness, if you take plus plus, it will not be exact, or minus minus, it will not be exact. That's all you have to remember. Okay, so where, what are these? I1 is inclusion in inclusion map, I2 is inclusion here, J1 is also an inclusion, and J2 also inclusion correspondingly. Okay, so Mayer-Vittrey sequence is one of the major ready to use tool in computing homology. As a simple consequence of Mayer-Vittrey sequence, we are going to prove this one, but that we will do it next time. It's already time now. We will stop here.